ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه، أرسله المولى تبارك وتعالى بالهدى ودين الحق يظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. فعليه وعلى آله وصحبه من سار على نهجه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد، عباد الله، اتقوا الله، اتقوا الله فإنها وصية الله إليكم. قال سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. My dear respected brothers, we already, alhamdulillah, covered some of the articles of faith by talking about the meaning of the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His angels, His books, His prophets and messengers. Today we'll move to another pillar of the faith, which is very important, and this is the belief in the hereafter, the belief in the last day. Why it was called the last day? Because there will be no days after that day. It will be the last day where the people of paradise will go to their places and palaces and the enjoyment and the pleasures that Allah Azza wa Jal prepared for His sincere servants. And those who opposed His message, disobeyed Him, disbelieved in Him and His messengers and His books, they will face their punishment. The belief in the hereafter is very important in the life of the Muslim, because there is no meaning for this life if there is no day for accounting. So everybody will pay for whatever he did in this world and in this life. If it was good, it will be good. Otherwise, it will be punished. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّوْنَ أُجُورَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازْ وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. Every soul will taste death, and you will only be given your full compensation on the day of resurrection. So he who is drawn away from the fire and admitted to paradise has attained his desire, attain the pleasure and the winning. And what is the life of this world except the enjoyment of delusion? No matter how much, how long one live in this world, one day he will leave. My dear brothers, we are in this world, in this life, like a company of riders in a bus or train that pass many stations, as we see people. And in every station, some people will leave the bus. This is the example of this life. We don't know when will be our day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only one who knows when every soul will taste death. The wisdom of that the Muslim, the believer, should be always ready. Always ready for the departure of this world. Ready with what? With the good deeds. With deep belief. With sincerity that one day he will leave this world. Nobody knows when is the hour. This is the question that our beloved Jibreel alayhi salam asked our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he asked him about the articles of faith and the pillars of Islam, and then he asked him about the hour. What does it mean, the hour? The time of the end of this life, of this world. What was the answer of Jibreel alayhi salam? مَا الْمَسْؤُولُ عَنْهَا بِأَعْلَمِ مِنَ السَّائِلِ. The one you ask, the question one, has no more knowledge than the one who is asking. That means both Jibreel alayhi salam, who is the best of all angels, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who is the best of the creation, they don't have the knowledge of the hour. No one knows it except Allah Azza wa Jalla. قال سبحانه وتعالى يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها قل إنما علمها عند ربي لا يجليها لوقتها إلا هو ثقلت في السماوات والأرض لا تأتيكم إلا بغتة يسألونك كأنك حفي عنها قل إنما علمها عند الله ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. They ask you, O Prophet of Allah, about the hour. When is its arrival? Say, its knowledge is only with my Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala. None will reveal its time except him. It lays heavily upon the heavens and the earth. It will not come upon you except unexpectedly. We don't expect. When a time people are heedless, they are not aware of this, it may strike them. They ask you as if you are familiar with it. Say, its knowledge is only with Allah, but most of the people do not know. This is in Surah Al-A'raf, verse number 187. This is the hour. And this not only, as we said, the hour of the whole world, but the hour of every person. Every one of us has certain time, which is his hour, when he leaves this world. And nobody knows it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are, my dear brothers, we are very close to this time. We are the nation that we are at the end of this world. Sending Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is one of the signs of the hour. Because he is the last messenger. He is the last messenger. And this nation is the last of all nations. So what do you expect after this? That means the time is very soon to come. And there's many signs. Because when Jibreel alayhi salam, when the Prophet asked Jibreel alayhi salam, or Jibreel alayhi salam asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam about the hour, and he told him that none know it except Allah, he asked him about what are the signs for this hour. So the Prophet alayhi salam mentioned some of these signs. One of the signs is the sending of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The advent of Prophet Muhammad alayhi wa sallam is one of the signs of the hour. Because he alayhi salatu wa sallam said, بُعِثْتُ أَنَا وَالسَّاعَتِكَ هَاتَيْنَ. I was sent with the hour like this. That means they are very close. So the coming Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a sign that the hour or the end of the world is getting very near. The ulama of Islam, they classified the signs of the hour into three categories. They said there's minor, there's middle, and there's major. The minor of the hour, the signs, all of them already happened. As we mentioned, the coming of the Prophet ﷺ and انشقاق القمر, قال عز وجل, اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر. The hour has come near and the moon has split into two parts. And we all know from the seerah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام that this splitting happened at the time of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام when the people of Quraysh, they asked him about sign to show that he is a messenger of Allah. And they asked him, can you make this moon split into two pieces? So he عليه الصلاة والسلام asked Allah عز وجل. And it happened at that night that the moon split it in two pieces. And they can see the mountain between them. One of this side of the mountain and the other part of the other side of the mountain. But then what they said? They said, this is illusion. This is magic. SubhanAllah. So Allah Azza wa Jalla is mentioning this as this is one of the signs of the hour. The minor, as we said, it's already happened. The middle signs, they started, and every day we see more. Some of these signs, these tall buildings, this, as you see it everywhere now, they cross maybe the sky or the clouds. This is one of the signs of the hour. The Prophet عليه السلام ترى الحفات الرعاة رعاة الإبل والشاة يتطاولون في البنيان. He will say these bear footed, the shepherds, they are compete. Who will build more higher building? And we can see this competition now. This is one of the signs of the hour. Some of the hour, the signs is the spread of many markets and shopping centers. Kathratul Aswaq. And you see it now. 50 years ago, maybe you signed most of the world that there's only one central shopping center or one central market. Nowadays, look, in one city, every day they open a new mall or shopping center. This is one of the signs of the hour. And there are many to come. These are the middle. How about the major? The major signs of the hour did not come. Because when it's start, it will follow one after another. Among them is the coming of the Dajjal, Antichrist, or the false Christ. And the coming, the advent of Isa alayhi salam, ibn Maryam, when he come down to kill the Dajjal. And go, and Ya'juj wa Ma'juj, Gog and Magog. And this means in Surah Al-Kahf, that this is sign. The coming of Ya'juj wa Ma'juj is one of the signs of the major signs of the hour. So my dear brothers, the Muslim, as we said, always should be ready. And especially if we see all these signs, this should give us more motive to be prepared. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim. رزقني وإياكم العلم النافع والعمل الصالح إنه جواد كريم استغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. My dear brothers, believing in the hereafter include numerous things that we should understand. First of all, believing in the resurrection. What does it mean, resurrection? That means Allah عز وجل will return all these people to life again for the judgment. So death is not the end of our life. As some people, or those who didn't believe in Allah, they think. This is the belief of the Bajan and some of those people who don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is not the end. If death is the end, as one poetry said, then he will say, death is the risk for everyone. Anyone in trouble, when he die, he will take risk. But it's not the end. After this, after man, woman leave this world, he will be resurrected again. He will come to life again. And then he will be questioned about every single thing that he did in this world. So the first thing that we should believe about the hereafter is the resurrection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, زَعْمَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَلَّا يُبْعَثُوا قُلْ بَلَى وَرَبِّي لَتُبْعَثُنَّ ثُمَّ لَتُنَبَّأُنَّ بِمَا عَمِلْتُمْ وَذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Those who disbelieve have claimed that they will never be resurrected, say, yes, by my Lord, you will surely be resurrected. Then you will surely be informed of what you did and Allah, and that for Allah it's easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this man from nothing from the beginning, is able to return him again to this world, including also in the belief in the hereafter, the belief in the reward and the punishment when everyone is judged. قال سبحانه وتعالى ونضع الموازين القسط ليوم القيامة فلا تظلم نفس شيئا وإن كان مثقال حبة من خردل أتينا بها وكفى بنا حاسبين. And we place the scales of justice for the day of resurrection, so no soul will be treated unjustly at all. And if there is even the weight of mustard seed, we will bring it forth, and sufficient are we as accounted. So, believing in the resurrection and believing in also counted. Also, the belief in paradise and hell, belief in the Jannah and An-Nar. That means they exist, and there will be the last places for people. People after this world, there's two places. Only two ways. Either to Jannah or to hell. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وكذلك أوحينا إليك قرآنا عربيا لتنذر أم القرى ومن حولها وتنذر يوم الجمع لا ريب فيه فريق في الجنة وفريق في السعير. And thus we have revealed to you an Arabic Quran that you may warn the mother of the cities, that's mean Mecca, and those around it, and warn the day of assembly, gathering, about which there is no doubt, party will be in paradise and party in the place. So these are some of the points that we need to learn about the hereafter. Inshallah, in our next khutbah, we'll maybe discuss some of the advantages of the belief in the, or the effect of the belief in the hereafter in the life of the Muslim. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم صل وسلم وأنعم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد. وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين الأئمة المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة والتابعين ومن سار على نهجهم إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام وانصر المسلمين واحمي حوزة الدين واجعل اللهم هذا البلد رخاء سخاء آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا ودورنا واصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا واجعل ولايتنا فيمن خافك واتقاك واتبع رضاك برحمتك يا مجيب السائلين يا رب العالمين. اللهم وفق ولي امرنا ما فيه رضاك وتقواك وهيئ له البطانه الصالحه الناصحه التي تدل على الخير وتعينه عليه برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا مجيب الدعوات إنك جواد كريم. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.